Historic Gray Eagle, located in Asheville, the Pearl of Carolina. It's the Travis Book Happy Hour. This week with special guests, Andy Dunnigan and the Reverend Matthew Rieger of the Lil Smokies. And featuring the Happy Hour House Band of Matthew Rieger and Andy Dunnigan. And now, your host, Travis Book.
Thank you. Thank you, fellas. Thank you so much. What a wonderful house band. Thank you all. Thank you all for being here tonight. And of course, thank you, Bill, for that fantastic intro.
You're welcome.
Yeah, nice job. All right, this all snuck up on me, and here we are. That's great. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in. Everyone out there tuning in on the internet, and all of you here in the house. I'm excited about tonight's show. I had a great show with these guys last night in Brevard, and I forgot to tune my guitar before I came up here, so here we are. I've been having a good time with these guys. They stayed at my house this weekend. Excuse me, they stayed at my house the last couple nights. Oh, that's not right. That's not gonna work. We're off to a great start. You know, last week we started the show and the cable didn't work. That actually was nice because I could blame something other than myself. Today I was just so busy yucking it up with the fellas backstage, I didn't even bother to think about how this show was gonna start. So we're easing into it tonight. I thank you all for your patience. If there's one thing that the great pause has taught us, it is patience. I'm almost there. Almost there. So excited to be playing music with these guys tonight. Big fan of the Lil Smokies. I've got some fun things to talk to them about. There's a lot of stuff that I probably shouldn't tell you about. A lot of conversations we've had that I'm hoping to dodge some of our history tonight, but we'll see. It might come up.
Always thought that you would fly, sail away and learn to ride. But you're waiting on a change in time. I take a train and catch a flight. Go ahead, it'll be alright. There's no one that you owe it to. You'll do what you want to do. Start the car, leave tonight. Go ahead, it'll be alright. I'll still be here, but it'll be alright. Drive out past the city lights, watch the dead turn into night. You'll be feeling better by midnight. A winding road will make it right. Go ahead, it'll be alright. What is past is done. No use holding on, don't look back. that old house is gone. It's the ground it rested on. Turn out that light. Don't look back, it'll be alright. You better take your chances when they come. Don't wait for something, no. Someone you hate to miss a chance at life, so go ahead, it'll be all right. Just say yes, it'll be all right. Some,
like some, I don't even know what to say. You know, it's like sometimes I'm all like stressed out and I'm worried about stuff. That's usually when stuff is actually pretty tight. But today, like today, I just am not in the mood to be stressed out about anything. I just don't have time for it. I don't have the bandwidth. My mother moved in with me this last week. Does anybody out there have their mother live with them? Wow.
Mother-in-law.
Whoa. Dang. I mean, Mom, I know you're watching right now, Mom, and I love having you at the house. And it's actually not nearly as dramatic as I thought it would be. So it's certainly going to be okay. It'll be all right, as the song says. But wow.
Yeah. Here, I tell you what, I'll play another song. I was gonna talk about some stuff tonight, but I'm just not really in the mood to wax too philosophical. So now I'll tune back to the place that my guitar was at when I came on stage. I was back there and the intro was happening. Bill was giving me that bang up intro. And I was like, that guitar is not in tune. But I'm going up there anyway. Oh. I appreciate you all being here. I appreciate your patience. And I appreciate you coming out to support live music here at the Grey Eagle in Asheville. Big thanks to the Grey Eagle for having us. It's interesting times, you know, and we just go day by day by day by day. And if you'd like to make a donation or tip the band, help us get paid, you can Venmo at TravisBook or paypal.me/TravisBook1. Backsplash is what's behind your sink, right?
Am I the only one here breathing? Am I the only one awake? Is mine the only heart that's beating? The choir. Almost more than I can take. I have painted all these walls, still they haunt me. I have waited for so long, still I'm wanting at night. Wander through my memories of a world seemed like only passing shows. but still, it's only just a reimagining of a world was written long ago. Should be sleeping. I am listening instead. Get the feeling that I'm not alone. I'm not. Of all my wondering, am I to see the beauty through the years? Can I peel away the layers of longing? Can I learn to live with all my fears?
Thank you. There's a line in that song. It's only just a reimagining of what was written long ago. And tonight, we talked. The boys and I talked about maybe using the word remembering as sort of an idea for a jumping off point for conversation. And I think that's an interesting perspective, an interesting plane of reality, one in which it makes sense. The perspective that this is all sort of unfolding naturally, sort of as it will happen. And not that things are predestined, but certainly that things are working. Everything is sort of working its way toward some sort of sense of, you know, harmony or centeredness or that sort of thing. And furthermore, I'd like to talk to him about is I'm not putting words together very well today. It's not my talking day. Some days you eat the bear. Some days the bear eats you. Anyway, the idea that Ram Dass talks about how we're you love, you serve, and you remember. A big part of what it means to go inside and to go into the spirit is to sort of remember who you are. what your original face was, and also to remember, sort of remember your place in it. Not so much discover it, but actually like remember it as though it already sort of unfolded. Doesn't make much sense, but next week I'm gonna have my talker working real good. So tune in next week. I think I have time for one more before I get these guys out here. Yeah. It's just one of those days, you know? Let's see, what am I gonna play? There is you can if you have complaints, you can log them on the Travis Book Happy Hour Facebook page. I'd be happy to hear your opinions about the first segment of tonight's show. Let me see if I can remember this. I mean, I'm not upset about it, but let's see.
My old friend, I recall times we had out hanging on my wall. I wouldn't trade them for gold. The laugh and the cry beat somehow sanctify me, woven in the stories I have told. Tell again, my old friend, I apologize for the years that have passed since the last time you and I dusted off those memories. The running and the races, the people and the places, there were always somewhere else I had to be. Time wears thin, my old friend. Don't know why. My old friend, this song's for you, 'cause a few simple verses was the least that I could do to tell the world that you were here. The love and the laughter will live on long after all of the sadness and the tears. We'll meet again, my old friend. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye,
thank you. I don't know who wrote that song, but I know Tim McGraw recorded it, and it's actually kind of an awesome version. I learned that one, though, from an old-time banjo player named Sam Amadon. Thank you, Sam, for turning me on to that. So without further ado, we're not even going to stop for a commercial break. That's how excited I am to get these guys up here, get this part of the show going. So if you will please make welcome two wonderful musicians, hilarious people, Reverend Matthew Rieger and Andy Dunnigan from the Lil Smokies. Welcome to the show, fellas.
Thank you for having us.
Shall we get comfortable and sit?
Yeah.
Now that I have you seated, I will remain standing to maintain an air of authority.
It's important. Demonstrate authority.
We need a couch out here.
I know, I thought of that. Mm-hmm. Hey, so, fellas.
Yeah.
Sorry. Thanks so much for being here.
Thank you for having us.
Let me just get this situated. Obviously, we have time. So, fellas.
Yeah.
Are you guys okay? You guys doing okay?
That's a tough question.
No. I mean, right now, yes, I am. But in the grand scheme of things, it's been weird for a musician in 2020. It's been weird for all of us. But yeah, do you want me to elaborate?
I mean,
we got time.
It is the happy hour, so
it's you asked.
It's okay if you're not okay. But not here.
Yeah, exactly.
No, man, I guess the next question would be, like, what have you been up to? What have you guys been up to?
Well, quick answer on that last one. I go back and forth, and it comes in waves. It's not so much linear. It's cyclical. And big picture, I am okay because I have this. I have you two. I have y'all. I have a community that I know is there that has not forgotten. I haven't forgotten everyone. I did for a little bit. And then doing things like this has really bolstered my confidence and optimism about the future. In terms of what I've been doing, I did put out a humble offering, a solo EP. Thank you. It's available on all the streaming services. And I hope you listen to it. It's a pretty candid picture of how I feel, which is, generally speaking, sort of melancholy, but I think it's important to embrace those moments and recognize that we're all going through melancholy moments and waves.
Yeah.
So you celebrate the good and the bad and lean into whatever you're feeling. That's what I've been up to.
Yeah.
I didn't put anything out, but I kept myself busy. I was up in Canada when all this stuff happened. We were on tour in the East. I think it was like March 11th or so. We were in Boston, and that's the kind of the night that everything changed. Like, we got off stage.
That's the day.
Yeah. We got off stage, and in that duration of the set, I think we came back to the green room, and the NBA was canceled, and Tom Hanks had the virus, and we just sat there in kind of disbelief. And then, you know, I flew back up to Canada where my girlfriend is, and I live... So I was up there for 5 months and kind of kept myself occupied on doing Zoom shows and whatnot. Yeah. Yeah. That was really fun to connect with a lot of fans, and especially during such a tumultuous time. But summer-wise, I had one of the best summers ever because I got to go hiking, and I got to see friends and family and camp and be outside. And I've neglected that. I think we all have, being on the road, and we'd be in airports or at a lonely hotel. So I did have a truly awesome silver lining summer that I'll always remember.
Well, that to me seems like that's sort of what these times ask of us, and the real opportunity is to sort of, I think a lot of people that are suffering right now are suffering because they have preconceptions about how things should be or how they were going to be, and they can't let them go.
Yeah.
And I understand that. It can be a hard thing. It's very difficult to make a hard pivot, and especially, you know, we are creatures of habit, and we like to know, you know. And I feel like my friends that are good at dealing with uncertainty are thriving right now.
Yeah.
You know, because it's and that has really been the opportunity for me, is to sort of let go of my ideas about how things were going to be,
yeah,
and just kind of take it day by day, as they say. You know, it's too weird to figure out.
It
so
is.
Why try?
Yeah,
you know. And it's like we were talking last night. You're like, when do you think we'll? And I'm like, well, what are we even? I don't know we'll do what. Do what? Like, I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't even know what terms to even start talking about what it is we want to be talking about for the future. I mean, it's just so It's pretty juicy time.
It's big.
Juicy.
It's pretty juicy. Hey, when did, do you guys remember, like, I was trying to pinpoint when we met. I can remember, like, I can remember distinctly the two first good hangs I had with either one of you, but I don't know, I kind of can't remember, like, when we first crossed paths.
I was trying to think of that last night, too. I remember back when we had a mandolin player, ran into you, me and our bass player, Scott Parker. Shout out to Scott. Yeah.
Scott. What's up, Scott?
We ran into Travis in the backstage at Telluride. Yeah, and Telluride, shout out to Telluride. And we said we had some problems. I think you sort of read our face, though. And we just seemed to always come across Travis at kind of moments of a pivot. That we needed career advice or life advice, that you'd give us advice and we would follow it. So we shortly after got rid of our mandolin player.
You came to me with a common problem.
Yeah, yeah.
And I gave you some perspective.
Perspective.
Unique perspective based on my unique situation of having been in a very similar situation.
Yeah.
Interpersonal dynamics are hard.
Yep.
Bands are like a family, except you can't ask your family not to come to the gig anymore.
I think it's supposed to depend on political beliefs from time to time. But.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. There's always that. So Telluride. I remember distinctly hanging out backstage at Telluride, and you and I had a beautiful moment on the beach at Mexico.
Yeah, that was the first one that came to mind.
Really?
We sang love songs to each other at sunrise.
I think I may have fallen asleep in your arms that morning.
It was a beautiful morning. And the human pyramid did not go well.
No, the human pyramid at Strings and Soul never goes well.
It doesn't, I suppose in that it kind of always goes well in that case, I guess.
Exactly. What else what are you really expecting from a human pyramid at 7 a.m.? Everything, apparently. So we've known each other for a little while, but this is really like the first good chance we've had to play music and spend time together. And I really appreciate, these guys came all the way from Montana, and they're out here trying stuff and taking risks, and that's pretty much like all we can do at this point.
That's
But we do appreciate you coming here. Rev, last night we were discussing a song that we're gonna play here in a little bit, and we were talking about the concept of like things sort of, again, words are, sometimes I'm good with words. Tonight's not such a good word night, so I'm gonna try to articulate this. Some element of almost like some of these songs, it's almost like they exist beforehand, or as your role as a songwriter is to kind of bring them into form. And I feel like sometimes I can hear a song and I can almost be I don't wanna sound like a jerk, but to be like, well, that person obviously didn't, they had some part in writing that, but there's something, like you hear a song and you're like, wow, there's something deeper going on there, right? There's something almost like predestined about its existence.
Sure. I think you could almost say that every song that ever has been written has already been written, and they're just out there buzzing around and waiting for the right time and the right person. I think most of the things that I've done that I really am proud of in my life came from letting go of trying to do them. And like any song that I've written that I like, it's just, you wait. You put out the intention, you're there and present and listening. And then when it's the right time, that song just sort of flows through. You're a medium, for the divine.
Couldn't have put it better myself.
I wouldn't say that about myself in any way, shape, or form, but it did kind of work into that.
Well, it sounds presumptuous when one says it about oneself,
well,
right?
Matthew is, it does mean gift from God, which is a lot of pressure.
Divine.
You wear it well.
Thank you. Thus far, yet to be proven, but it's been a good, I've been trying.
Yeah, I mean, I think you point to something that I've thought about a lot as a musician is, for people who can't make music, there has to be a medium between what I feel like is almost like sort of pre-existing, which is this, I don't know, music, energy, or something, some sort of trajectory or something, potential, right? and then bringing that into form so that it can then be experienced, right? Because if everybody could just do that, then everyone would just do that. You wouldn't need bands. You could just connect to the source through the music yourself all the time. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Well, I think it goes beyond music, too. It goes in every area of life. Whatever you want from it, whatever you'd like to be, if you're listening for the opportunities and paying attention, you're far more likely to accomplish those things. Whether it be a song or a job or a relationship, if you're listening, it can come.
Right, cultivate the spaciousness for it to occur.
Yeah.
For it to unfold. That's pretty
good, bro.
That was nice.
That was divine.
That's nice.
Thank you. I'll be here for another hour and 20 minutes or so.
This reminds me a little bit of this Saturday Night Live skit that I used to see.
My life is a Saturday Night Live skit.
I think it was called The Delicious Dish. And it was NPR, and it was Molly Shannon and you know, another actress. And they were like, oh, yes, it's so delicious. So you take the rosemary and you make... And it was, you know, very monotone and very NPR. You know, this felt... That was nice. It was very NPR of us. Yeah, man, it's so... I just love talking about that stuff. Mm-hmm. I love, like, I use, like, matters of being as a catch-all phrase for what I think is kind of the greatest question of spirituality, which is how to be, and what is going on, and what do we do? What is our role in all of it? And I just find that so fascinating. And I've had to think a lot about sort of what my role is in all of this. Mm-hmm. This entire unfolding, the political situation that's going on right now, what my role is, and the ongoing health crisis, like sort of like what, because I think it's very easy to sort of think of some sort of universal response that everyone should have, but really everyone plays a different role in this whole, the whole Leela, the whole dance.
Yeah.
And figuring yours out is weird.
Have you guys been writing during this time?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You?
A little bit. Yeah, it's starting to come there. That's always been kind of a, I mean, we have the time now, but I feel like it's more of a space thing, and space can be ambiguous, where space can be, you know, when you're on the road, that's always a hard time to write, because you never have a moment by yourself. Or if you do, you just kind of want to sleep
yeah.
and recover. But now that I do have the time, it's everything's so wild that I think I'm sort of gathering, I'm filling the sponge. Like there's been some moments and some fragments, so I can kind of feel when that sponge is full and is about to expel, so to speak. But yeah.
It's been interesting not having the muse of the road. Momentum, motion, excitement has always really fueled my writing, and it was interesting to have that pulled out from underneath you and still try to come up with meaningful thoughts. Mm-hmm. So I tried to write some stuff from like the past and old memories instead of the most recent ones, and it's been weird getting there though. Again, with things like this, I feel much more inspired. Just seeing other people, other musicians that we don't get to hang out with, it's been really helpful.
Yeah, old. You say like old memories, and that's always something interesting too for me to talk about.
Yeah.
It's like the idea of remembering and our attachment to those memories and the stories that we tell ourselves about what happened. And I'm always sort of fascinated by there's always some distance between sort of your narrative of the unfolding and the reality of the unfolding, right? and I like to wonder, like, how far off is that, you know? Yeah. And there's kind of no way to really know what happened because you were in the midst of it.
Yeah.
And your entire experience was colored by everything in your own mind and your own experience, you know? So that's a fascinating thing when you see, like, you sort of like plumb your memories about like things that have happened. You look back and it's more than ever, I feel like I don't even know that I can trust my own storyline about my own life.
Yeah.
So true.
Yeah, that's kind of like songs are little prehistoric, like a bug set in amber. You know, I've always thought where like that's a little scrapbook entry into a moment of my life or a period of time, like albums or, you know, you remember where you were when you wrote a certain song and what that feels like and what everything smelled like in the apartment or whatever. And that's a really cool thing to have, especially during this time when, you know, we haven't been able to see each other and play music, but you could still play those songs and still feel whatever that feeling was still inherently there.
Yeah. You guys are, what do you, I don't really know how to talk about this either, but like, what do you guys, neither one of you seem to be particularly like religious or dogmatic types, but you do seem sort of engaged in the pursuit of understanding the source. You seem like spiritual beings. What do you do?
Divine.
It was a compliment.
Yeah, thank you. That's nice of you to say.
You are divine. I mean, I recognize that in you.
What?
Matthew.
What is it? Namaste? The divinity in me? Recognize the divinity in you? What do you... I mean, you know, maybe this is a lame question, but like, what do you do? What are your practices, or what sort of brings you to that place where you feel that sort of unitive, you know, consciousness? If that's not too personal.
No, it's not too personal, and it's a simple one. It's still just music. If I can just find the energy and the space in myself to pick up the guitar, pick up whatever's around, and just go. It's obviously I don't run, but I've heard that people get runner's high.
It's not that obvious.
and that's how I feel with a lot of times when I'm not doing well spiritually and I want to be better. I just start playing, and even if I don't want to play, I just keep playing. And so Peter Gabriel, Paul Simon, and for the last week, Van Halen, have kept me going in that way where I mainly Peter Gabriel, and it's because when we had to shut everything down, I drove the van from Burlington, Vermont to Boulder, Colorado, and I listened to Peter Gabriel for Western New York, Pennsylvania, and even I think into Ohio is next or something like that. I thought if this song, in particular, In Your Eyes, if this song can help me feel like I'm going to be okay, it is my duty, my divine obligation to keep trying. And so I haven't found anything else like that. I would love to think that there are others out there, but that's all I can come up with.
Yeah. Yeah, I... I mean, music's the first obvious choice, especially when you're in the moment. It's all about being in the moment and being able to forget about everything that's going on peripheral, you know. So I think songwriting was kind of when I first discovered that, or playing music when you're on stage and everything, or you're not on stage, you're practicing and you're just in that moment. Everyone's feeling it. But outside of that, the do run. I have discovered that, but I think being outside, I grew up in Montana, and I spent a lot of summers in Glacier National Park, and did a lot of backpacking, and climbing on top of mountains, and just being out, you know, in the, just seeking solace and refuge outside, and that's been a really important thing in my life, and again, I kind of rediscovered that this summer, so... Yeah, but again, I think it's just about transcending and being here, you know, being in the moment.
Totally. It seems like that is essentially what all fingers are. That's the moon that all fingers are pointing toward.
Yeah.
As they say, I think, you know, you talk about that being outside, that spaciousness. I mean, nothing makes it's sort of like the phenomenon that happened to the astronauts when they get out there and they can see the entire Earth. It really shifts that perspective. I think you get the same thing from standing on a mountain, or even just being away from other energy fields. Your energy Venn diagram uncoupled from anything else, and to be alone and quiet and still, you know? And that's something that, as a culture, it's harder and harder and harder for us to do. I mean, and like, I can't sit down. I can't go to the toilet without my phone.
Yeah.
I mean, I can't even like enjoy that beautiful, transcendent experience of a morning bowel movement without bringing Instagram into it.
See, that's,
you know?
That's a good point, yeah.
And I know you all take your phone to the toilet too. And we all are taking our, whatever our phone is,
to whatever our toilet is all the time. I mean, it's just, we're sort of cramming experience on top of experience, and a lot of it is inside, and a lot of it is done through the screen, and a lot of it is and it is really easy to see people as other and to separate yourself from that sort of unitive consciousness when you are not really in unity with anything except for your cell phone, which I love dearly. Don't touch my phone, by the way.
Pro Max.
Because I can't go to the bathroom without it. All right, moving on. Rev, what are you afraid of?
I don't think I don't fear anything right now. I probably should. It would be wise. But I was waiting for something to come when you said that. Like, what am I afraid of? I'm afraid that, you know, on a superficial level, that there are things that are going to be taken from our careers that we might not get back. I think, again, music is the forefront of my life. It's at the forefront. It's always there. And so when I think about what shows brought to people and to myself, it was community. It was a letting down of our guard, not being afraid to hug and dance and all that. And so having that pulled out and wondering if that will return, when it will return, if it will, is a lingering fear. Because the music is, it serves the community and the coming together. It's a catalyst, but it's not the only thing that's happening when you go to a show.
Totally.
It's really just a way for that sense of community to come together. And so if we're talking about things that I fear, I suppose I can point to that, but in the end I believe in us, and I think that we'll be able to find ways to get through this. So a final answer, no, I don't have any fears.
Yeah, me neither. Dunnigan, what is it that gives you hope?
What is it that gives me hope?
That's a tougher question.
I mean, if you're afraid of something and you want to talk about it, you can too.
I mean, hope. Hope's been a tough one lately, a little bit.
I know. I know. That's why I asked, because I need some help.
Yeah. I mean, this gives me hope, but again, about, like what you said, I mean, I am afraid to tie it in with the hope. I seek a lot of salvation from the community that I had that was derived on the road in these shows, and that's always been kind of my spirituality and church, for, you know, like going to these festivals and seeing the communities that have been going to Telluride, for instance, you know, that have been going for decades, and all these crazy people that we get to meet along the interstate has been so awesome, and that used to give me a lot of hope, and to have that ripped away has been really challenging. You know, I think right now, this actually, like the last couple weeks, I went back, because I never finished college. I went to the University of Montana for creative writing, and then I joined started the Lil Smokies, and then kind of my grades crashed. So during the last month, I went back, and the plan B of what if music doesn't happen again kind of crept in. And you know, having a plan B as an artist is always, you know, supposedly the enemy, you know, because if you have a plan B, if you have a backup plan, and if you're not all in with music, it might not come into fruition. So this last month, I kind of went back online and checked up my grades, and that was like going in a time capsule back in time, and it scared the shit out of me.
That's terrifying.
Because I was like, how much has changed in the last 8 months that I'm even like looking at this right now? So, I mean, I don't, it's all going to come back, and that gives me hope, because things like this and people like yourself, Travis, who are kind of reinventing the wheel, and if it has to happen in different facets, I know that humans can adapt, and what we did with Zoom and, you know, if we have to live online a little bit for now, I think it's great too, you know, because we still can connect and see each other and be empathetic, because it is a tough time right now, and we need each other.
Yeah, we really do.
And speaking of, we love doing those Zoom shows. Thank you. Seems like maybe we've, they're, aside from rent and stability, in that way, it provides us just, that time we spend with y'all recharges me for days. And helps alleviate some of those fears and inspire some hopes. So I hope you'll go to our website, littlesmokies.com, and if you're interested, please do try one out. It would mean the world to us.
That's awesome. We jumped in on one last night, and it looked like it was fun.
They were the three of us were all together for one of my Zoom shows, and that was really exciting. Thank you.
So real quick, last question, short answer. What makes you guys happy? What brings you happiness right now?
It's a tough one.
Bummer, dude. I got a friggin' laundry list of stuff that makes me happy. Yeah. Even this conversation makes me happy. Can you tell? Even having you sit there on the hot seat makes me happy.
You know, the Paloma margarita that I just had made me very happy. Yeah. I'm certain that the burrito, the post-show burrito, will make me happy. Getting together with bandmates and friends that, you know, like you were saying earlier, we know each other. We've known each other for a while, but it's so quick, so fleeting when we do get to see each other, that to have the chance to actually hang out for a few days, rehearse, play some music together, that's made me really happy. We did Andy and I played with the Lil Smokies in Missoula was it 2 weekends ago or something like that. And that's it. That's what's really keeping me going and making me happy is knowing that we will be able to have time together as musicians and friends.
Yeah.
And daiquiris, margaritas.
Yes. Palomas.
The Paloma margarita, the Paloma is a fantastic drink.
It really is.
I prefer it to the margarita.
The Paloma margarita is it's like a little bit of like a turducken or like an SUV. It's like you can't get enough. Yeah, you want it all.
Yeah.
Anything else make you happy there, Donovan?
Yeah, I mean, I got a really great girlfriend up in Canada that I'm going to get to go back up to here in a month. I got an exemption from the Canadian government for a family reunification.
Nice. Thanks, Canada.
Yeah. So I'm going to get the hell out of here for a
little while. They're so considerate up there.
Seems like a good time to do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, and just reconnecting with, you know, my family back in Montana. I got to do that over the summer. It's been good. So, again, community and music and feeling somewhat connected during this time and still somewhat hopeful.
Awesome. Well, that's Andy Dunnigan and Reverend Matthew Rieger from the Lil Smokies. You guys want to play us some music?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, get it set up. I'll tell a quick little anecdote while you guys are setting up there, you know, so we can keep the music rolling, keep the show rolling. The other day, these guys came into my house and, you know, I live a humble existence. I have a ranch. It's a little, not like a ranch house. Built in the 50s, you know, it's a nice little cracker box. And my mom's staying in the guest room, and I actually sleep in the den these days. And two bedrooms for the kids, right? So the guys are coming over, and I'm like, well, fellas, welcome to the house. I've got some beds and some bedrooms for you. I said, you know, it's the kids' bedrooms, and I hope that that's okay. And they were like, oh, yeah, that's no problem. And I said, well, you know, Jesus said, lest ye be like little children, ye cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. So it'll be good practice for you. You can be like little children. And sure enough, these guys slept like 15 hours last night.
Well, and Ruby's color scheme really jives with my own. It's a purple-pink vibe that I really like.
Is that
a memory foam mattress? Because it was comfy.
It's actually a 12-year-old IKEA mattress that's just laying on the floor. I wish I was classier than that, but let me tell you, I am not. I am not. Our mattresses are on the floor. Take it away, Rev.
Oh, that's right. Nice.
You're up.
Cool. Well.
It's all you, baby. All
right. Yeah, you know, I don't know where I'd be right now without the Lil Smokies. Thank you. Yeah. It was a drunken night in the woods in Washington State when I met them, and we had a wonderful time. And when we played the Wilma, I was thinking about the tidal wave from then to that moment on stage again at the same place where it all started. And I'm so grateful for that experience. To come back to it was wonderful. A lot of the songs that I write would not have been written were it not for my experiences with them. And this is one of them. I play it with them, and I also did a version of my own recently. Here we go. The There's a wheel on the water and a needle above. Alaska's time has come and gone. We tried to tear it down just a little too late and sang a song for an empty grave. I'm staring at a highway, holding to the line, waiting on an answer, hoping for the time. I'm tired of going back, afraid of losing sight. I'm hoping you remember what we got right. They tell me it's a garden, but I say it's a zoo. And I tell myself I'm just passing through. Dreaming of the days when our eyes were blue, and every word we sang was true. I'm staring at a highway, holding to the line, waiting on an answer, hoping for the time. I'm tired of going back, afraid of losing sight. I'm hoping you remember what we got right. But the quiet never lies. Quiet never lies, never lies, never lies. Change your reasons with a sleight of hand. Doesn't matter if I understand. Maybe better if we never see each other again. But I've said that before. I'm staring at a highway, holding to the line, waiting on an answer, hoping for the time. Tired of going back, afraid of losing sight. I'm hoping you remember what we got right. Hoping you remember what we got right. I'm hoping you remember what we got right. Thank you. Man, that was fun. And I do believe I'm going to hand this guitar over now, right? Yeah. What, do you want to play some guitar, Andy?
Yeah.
I'm going to bring Andy Dunnigan up here. Yeah, you can just pull whatever you need there.
Be my guitar tech, Rev. I still can't even reach that. It's so crazy.
Any work you got, I'm interested.
Yeah.
Whoa, 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 hey.
All right. Yeah, if I played standing up with this thing, I'd look so short. I really would. Talking about remembrance and whatnot, I remember being in this. I had a little tree fort apartment that I wrote a lot of songs off the Changing Shades album, and I remember being really excited when I wrote this little guitar melody, and it had a kind of an old time feel. But thank you.
into the pond. Watch the ripples twist as I made my wish, hoping you were on. And I've been rooting on the storm, rooting on the storm. Open my front door and applaud the pour. Never feel the rain anymore. Feathers start to weigh it down. Feathers start to weigh it down. They're gonna weigh it down. Let them go. Feathers start to weigh it down. Feathers start to weigh it down. They're gonna weigh it down. Let them go. Of the sun, the only saving grace is the changing shades, the shape you take when you're done. Feathers start to weigh you down. Feathers start to weigh you down. They're gonna weigh you down. Let them go. Feathers start to weigh you down. 2020 starts to weigh you down.
He's a heck of a guitar player, ain't he?
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. He's well, might as well, right? Let's see. What are we gonna do here? We had a plan. There was a plan, I do believe.
Found it.
Dude, where's my dobro? Said many a person. Are we going to do Better Times first or Tornado first?
Yeah,
so it's nice to be able to do some of my solo stuff with Andy here. We haven't had a chance to really do it. So we're going to give it a shot.
Give
me
7-2.
Oh yeah, hurry. Yeah, I'm from just north of Seattle, Washington, and this, listening or looking at the lyrics to most of my songs, they all are kind of about Seattle, and I recently figured out that I do have a home, and it is the Northwest. It was weird to accept that. It almost felt like a vulnerable position. That there is actually some place that is your home. After spending so many years not having one, or thinking that I didn't have one. So, a song about Seattle. What do you say there, dog?
Yeah.
Oh, one, two, one, two, three.
Oh.
forgot about that.
I detuned it. My bad.
No, hardly. There we go. All right.
Cool.
Back to our regularly scheduled song. One, two, three. Father's eyes, you were kind, you were strong, running, jumping, swimming, flying, you did it all, with all you had. Cabin if we get them all. you.
Cool. All
right, well, see some Lil Smokies?
Yeah.
When I first joined the band quite a few years ago, some of my friends thought I had joined a band called Lil Smokies.
That's a better name.
It's a, yeah. Yeah.
Let's play some Lil Smokies.
Let's play a Lil Smokies.
we're gonna play the title track of the latest album we just put out called Tornillo. Yeah, and me and Rev, I wrote this song and the little melody part, and then Rev, we were in Tornillo, Texas, outside of El Paso, right on the border of Juarez, Mexico, and Rev came up with this really cool little piano part, and I think this was the last song we recorded on that album.
It wasn't planned to record it that night, I don't think, either.
No, so it was definitely a different kind of... Yeah, just a different kind of lineup than we had. We got to experiment a little on this, and Rev played a beautiful part on the piano. So it's a gooey little love song. Usually I write breakup songs, so this is a love song. I think that means something.
Yeah.
Finding code and information, the fabric of the stars. But I know we need not go that far. Cause either way, time's our provision, the feelings supersede. Like you lying beside me. Everything slows when I'm with you. And everything slows when I'm with you. Today the winds here in Tornillo lifted sand and heated breeze. I felt something in me. Cause out here silence is serrated, insistent and implied. Distance helps you realize. Ooh, time flies so fast, it's true. Everything slows. Song to you today, but ooh, time flies so fast, it's true. But everything slows, and I'm with you, and everything slows, and I'm with you. Get Travis back. Oh, there he is.
Danny Dunnigan and Reverend Matthew Rieger. We're gonna take a short break for our sponsors and for the band, and we'll be back in about 60 seconds.
Lil Smokies, come on.
thank you, thank you. Welcome back. Thank you, Bill. Your love indeed is pushing me higher and higher. Let's play some music, fellas. This is the part of the, this is part of the show where we act like we're a band together.
Let's see here. What do we got to do? Oh, nice. Are we the same as last night, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kind of funkier.
Yep.
Yeah. I'm going to need just 1 second here.
Oh, for those of you watching at home, thank you again for tuning in. If you'd like to make a contribution, donation, or a tip for the band, you can do that at Venmo, Travis Book, or PayPal.me/TravisBook1. Any and all support is appreciated. Thanks to Rev. Thanks to Dunnigan. Yeah. Let's be a band.
Yeah.
Let's do our best.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Let's do a funky, yeah.
California, still holding your hand. Somewhere deep down there, I wish you the best inside me. Somewhere I wish you love and happiness. California, still holding your hand.
This trip and then of the whole, you know, weirdness that's been going on is you get to reimagine what a song can be.
Yeah.
You don't, it just doesn't matter anymore what it was because that isn't even real anyway.
It was never real to start with.
It was never real.
Damn you guys.
Yeah, I mean, once you start turning over those kind of rocks, it kind of never ends, you know? And that can be a little disorienting and a little scary, right? But that's all part of the process, you know? You gotta turn those rocks over. See what's under there.
Well, shall we, fellas? Yeah. Cool. One, two, three. There's a picture of a man that nobody ever knew. On the wall, waiting for the children who never heard the call. They're never coming home. Give me time to realize I could have done better. Give me patience when I say I don't know how. Locked door, call it a mansion. Give me one more chance, I swear I'll let you down. They'll call my name in the morning. We're playing to Tennessee, but I'm on Chicago in the darkest side of town. Wondering what you'll think. Give me time to realize I could have done better. Give me patience when I say I don't know how. Give me a locked door, call it a mansion. Give me one more chance, I swear I'll let you down.
That's the song that I was talking about earlier when I was talking about Rev's song feeling like it was old as time.
I love that tune, man. Nice. Really well done.
Yeah. Oh, sweet.
Now it's your turn, buddy.
Yeah, I'm in the hot seat now.
We're going to make Rev play bass. Good news is he's really good at it.
That's too kind.
It's a fact, man.
All right.
Bass solo, baby.
There's a line. There's a line that I can stand.
There's a line that we will not cross.
We will not cross.
Hey, we really are so grateful that you all came down tonight. We know a lot of you had no idea what this was going to be like, and here you are, and we hope you're satisfied. We hope you're enjoying yourselves.
Such a hard time. I need to hear you on the other end of the line. I want the cold wind to blow me back on down the road. I keep having the same bad dream. I wanna know exactly how to be. Well, the ones that I love, they don't know that I've been gone. I better head back home. Another drink and I might forget. I do some things that I might regret. When I get to the bottom, I only feel more alone. I better head back home. I can see it in my dream. I can feel that warm summer breeze. Will it still be standing there? Will it be gone. I see the lights of the old town. Gonna dig my roots deep into the ground. Let the moss gather on this old rolling stone. It's good to be back home. Oh, yeah, good to be back home.
always feel like you can tell a lot about a guitar player by the way they play the bass. And if that's the case, man, I don't really know what to say about you, actually. But that was some killer bass playing, brother.
Thank you.
Really awesome. Really really awesome. Thank you all so much for being here. It's a real honor to play with these guys and an honor to play for all of you tonight. So thanks for tuning in. Thanks for being here in the room.
Thank you, Travis. Travis Book.
Travis Book in the right.
Sandy Dunnigan over there. My name's Matthew Rieger, and that's Travis Book.
Thank you all so much. Thank you for coming. Thank you for listening, and thank you for tuning in. Thank you, Thompson Guitars, and thank you, I Am Asheville. Thank you, Grey Eagle. So many people to thank. So much to be grateful for. In spite of it all, so much to be grateful for. We're going to leave you with one tune here. It really has been an honor. Travis Book Happy Hour returns next week with my bandmate and dear friend Andy Falco. And then we'll be back again in mid-November with Anders Beck from Green Sky Bluegrass and Benny Galloway, the man who taught us everything we know. So please tune in for that.
Wait, were you in the band? The Stickley Burl?
I was in the band. And that band had a name. It was called the Broke Mountain Bluegrass Band.
I thought there was another one, though.
I was,
like,
well.
Didn't they do a hip-hop thing?
Hip-hop? Oh, well, we're getting a little off topic here,
oh, yeah.
But yes.
Pardon me, I didn't mean to do that.
But yes, John Stickley has recorded a couple of hip-hop tracks, and they are incredible. One is called Cape Fear Formal Wear, which he wrote about the formal wear rental place he used to work at and all the high school kids he would rent tuxedos to. It's very good rap. You can find it on the internet. The other one is called The Wayward Sons.
Oh, there
and
we
it's,
go.
And it's a rap about the band that Anders and Burl were in together. The Wayward Sons.
That was the one I was
They thinking. Don't fight. They don't use their guns. And you can find that Wayward, that's Word, W-O-R-D, and Sons with a Z. Please go right to YouTube after this episode and check out the amazing hip-hop rap by John Stickley. And as Anders Beck would say, yo, it's a dobro rest. Give me more jelly. That's all I have to say about that.
Sorry about that. We better stop saying things about that.
Remember.
In fact, it is now, as they say, time to move on.
All right, boys.
Time to move on, it's time to get going. What lies ahead, I have no way of knowing. But under my feet, baby, the grass is growing. Yeah, it's time to move on, time to get going. Yeah, broken skylines, moving through the airport. She's an honest defector, conscientious objector. Now we're on protector. Yeah, broken skylines. Which way to love land? Which way to something better? Which way to forgiveness? Which way do I go? Yeah, it's time to move on. It's time to get going. What lies ahead, I have no way of knowing. But under my feet, baby, grass is growing. Yeah, it's time to move on. Time to get going. Sometime later, getting the words wrong, wasting the meaning, losing the rhyme. As noisy as adrenaline, like breaking up a dog fight, like a deer in the headlights, frozen in real time. Now I'm losing my mind. Yeah, it's time to move on, it's time to get going. What lies ahead, I have no way of knowing. But under my feet, baby, grass is growing. Yeah, it's time to move on. Time to get going. Yeah, it's time to move on. It's time to get going. what lies ahead, I have no way of knowing. But under my feet, baby, the grass is growing. Yeah, it's time to move on. Time to get going. Yeah, it's time to move on. Time to get going.
Thank you so much.
Good job. Yeah. Good job. Yeah.
Thank you all. Thank you so much. Have a great night.